Hey, beautiful people, how are you today? Welcome to Sacred Knowledge Tarot. This is a pick a pile reading, and what we're going to do is ask spirit guides what the rest of your year is going to look like. Each pile has three cards in it, okay? So we've got amethyst as pile one, green citrine as pile two, yellow citrine as pile three, and rose quartz as pile four. So take a moment and really focus in on what stone or pile resonates with you the most. And then I'm going to have timestamps below for those of you that want to pick a pile and go straight to that reading. You are able to pick more than one pile, just so everyone knows. And those of you that are new to my channel, welcome. If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing. All right, so without further ado, let's get right into it. Hey, pile number one, those of you that chose amethyst, this is your reading. All right, let's just put this right over here. So we've got three cards here, and let's see what we're going to get here. We're getting Queen of Coins, Five of Wands, and King of Coins. All righty. So this is some really good energy here, okay? And what is a month or a couple months without any kind of conflict here? I've got a little bit of conflict coming in here, okay, for some of you. Not to worry, because it's not a big, big deal here, okay? So what I'm getting here is Queen of Coins. I feel like some of you are feeling very nurturing right now. You guys are really taking care of the things in your life, whether it's at work or at home or relationship, okay? You're being very sensible in just your surroundings and the way you're going about things. I think some of you are very down to earth as well. You're really kind of making things work as they come, okay? You're taking control of your life right now and really nurturing what needs to be nurtured at this moment. It's almost like you're being very motherly towards those around you and taking care of your needs or those around you, their needs, the needs of your home, the needs of your work, that sort of thing. So I'm getting that very strongly here with the Queen of Coins, okay? I feel there's also a little bit of insecurity in some of you out there, okay? There might be almost like you're feeling intolerant, or things for you may not be working as they seem, but truly I feel that they actually are, and it's something that's just in the back of your mind than it is actually coming forth in your life. It's just maybe a worry that you have that maybe just needs to be released as far as energy wise, okay? So I see that you're doing really well in taking care of things in your life right now. You're really on top of things as well. So that's looking really good for you. So I think for the rest of this year, this trend is going to happen for you, pile number one. You're gonna really be, taking onus of everything and really kind of nurturing your life a little bit and making sure everything is fine-tuned. You're taking care of the little things in your life, and you know, it's almost like mom energy, where you know, moms take care of everyone's needs. They're there for you. So I feel like you're being that nurturing self right now, okay? I do see a little bit of conflict coming in. I'm not sure where this is, but where in your life this is. But there's some sort of something happening where there's going to be a little bit of struggle with people in your life, okay? If it's not already happening. I do see a little bit of this happening towards the end of the year, middle to the end of the year here, okay? With the Five of Wands. Yeah, some sort of conflict or change. There's going to be a little bit of a few challenges coming your way. But I feel like with the Queen of Coins energy and also with the King of Coins energy, you're able to tackle this without any kind of turbulence or disturbance to you personally, okay? I think you're very good at handling any kind of challenges that come into your life. Things may seem a little unstable or a little chaotic, but it's almost like good chaotic in a way. That's what I'm getting here with the Five of Wands in this energy here. let's see here, the Five of Wands. What I feel like maybe it's a disagreement, a clashing of egos, or maybe there's a struggle happening here regarding opinions or something in your life. It could be any area of your life, work, home, friendships, but there is something that's going to come forth, come out, and there's going to be a little bit of turbulence, okay? So just be aware of that. With the King of Coins, I'm getting that you're very secure in your position right now in life. You're feeling very safe and protected, okay? You're a very reliable and disciplined person. I'm seeing with the Queen of Coins and the King of Coins, you're very stable and grounded right now, and I'm seeing abundance in your life. I'm seeing that things are working out for you, okay? And things are going to remain that way. Even though there's going to be a little bit of turbulence coming in, I feel like you're pretty sturdy and things are going to look good. And you're just doing really, really well. You're very secure, okay? And just be careful not to get obsessive or possessive or greedy over money. Okay, wealth and status, that sort of thing. Just be wary of that, because I feel like you're a very powerful person, okay? But you're also very nurturing. You're very kind and good to those around you. I'm seeing a lot of good things coming through here. I'm seeing money. Okay, so I feel like some of you may be getting promoted towards the end of the year, or you're going to get some sort of good news which is going to amplify your finances towards the end of this year. I'm getting that very strongly here, okay? Especially with the King of Coins. I feel like towards the end of the year, you're going to be very, like, in tune with yourself. You're very disciplined. You've got routines going. You've got structure. You're handling things very, very well. You're able to delegate and do things and just take care of the ones around you as well. So this is really, really good energy. So the rest of this year is looking very good for you, pile one. So that is something you have to look, you can look forward to, other than this little bit of struggle here that's going to come probably just before Christmas, I think. That's what I'm getting here, probably October, November. Okay, so whatever this is, you're very capable of overcoming it without it affecting you too much, okay? I know it might be a little stress, but yeah, there is definitely, I feel like this is more of clashing of egos, and possibly at work or maybe in a relationship at home, I'm feeling like. So I feel like there's going to be a few people involved. Maybe there's something going on at work here. I'm not sure, but something's going to happen. It's going to cause a little bit of chaos in your life. Just for a short period of time, okay? But you've got it all handled. It's not going to affect you too much, because you're very good at what you do and you're going to be able to handle it, okay? You're a king and you're getting the queen energy here. So this is really, really good for you. So that is your reading, pile number one. So that is what the rest of your year looks like. So I'm very happy with this reading. So thank you so much for watching. Hey, pile number two, those of you that chose green citrine, this is your reading. All right, let's see what cards we're getting. Three of Cups. Wonderful. All right, we're getting the Six of Cups here. The Four of Cups. And the Page of Wands. Wow, beautiful energy. I'm really, really liking this. So right off the bat, I'm seeing growth here, okay? For some of you, you guys are growing and expanding. There's a lot of creativity. I'm feeling a lot of collaborations and group work, but a lot of coming together here, okay? I'm also seeing manifestations coming into fruition here, okay? Stability and security in some of your future here for the rest of this year. And the Page of Wands as well. Wow. Okay, so lots of ideas, lots of good things going on here for you, pile number two. So with the Three of Cups, I'm seeing that there's a lot of focus on friendships, a lot of focus around the people that are in your life right now. I'm seeing gatherings, lots of coming together, social events, that sort of thing here, okay? A lot of collaborations, communities, all coming together. So I'm seeing you attending events quite a bit here. Okay, so a lot of social activity, for this, the rest of this year. Okay, whatever is going on, lots of good things, and this is celebrations. You are doing really, really well right now because there's a lot of growth happening, and maybe that's why. This could be networking as well. Maybe you're doing a really good job networking. Okay, especially if you're in the sales field. There's a lot of good things coming here. You're actually getting the sales, and you're getting a lot of companies on board, I'm feeling like, for those of you that are out there in the business world. There's a lot of good things coming, and you're celebrating because of this. I feel like a lot of you are really doing super good right now, and there's a lot of celebration around that. Okay, there's decisions being made as well. I think there is one big decision that has to be made by the end of this year for you. Okay, so you're really in deep thought and trying to decide what it is that you want to do. And this is going to be emotionally fulfilling for you, okay? With the Four of Cups. So I feel like, there's something going on here with this. Like a decision, you're contemplating something, okay? There might be, maybe you're kind of being very picky about who you get on board, but there's some sort of decisions and choices that have to be made. Some of you might be getting bored with all of this, you know, social events, and it's kind of like, okay, there's so much going on in my life right now. I have to pick and choose where I want to be right now. And that's what's happening. And the growth part as well. It's like a lot. I'm feeling like some of you are being offered jobs or positions, and you're getting multiple offers in here, and you're trying to figure out where you want to go or what you want to do. Okay. So there's a lot of decisions, a lot of thinking going on here. You know, you want to be emotionally fulfilled. So good things, celebrations, networking, collaboration sort of thing. And then decisions that you have to make and decide. Like, where do you want to put your energy, right? You're being very picky about it, you know? It could be love offers, too. I feel like some of you are out there meeting and mixing and mingling, especially if you're out there trying to find your soulmate. So you've got these choices in front of you, and you're really taking it seriously and wanting to make the right choice, okay? And with the Page of Wands, I'm seeing new ideas. I feel like you're very fearless, very, very happy, and you're discovering all these new things that are coming your way. I'm seeing fresh starts. A lot of like really good, fun, exciting energy here. Okay. Stability, security. I feel like some of you are even manifesting something. There's some sort of a manifestation coming into fruition here for some of you as well, pile number two. So whatever it is that you're trying to manifest, know that the universe has heard you. This is your confirmation, and you're going to get this manifestation come into reality probably towards the end of the year here, especially if you are on that path and you're making headway, especially if you're networking and making things happen for yourself and you're taking action, and then you're deciding and you're picking and choosing very carefully and wisely. Okay, there's lots of new things coming towards you towards the end of the year here around November, December. I'm seeing that right now very clearly. Okay, so really, really good, really exciting, very fun, very energetic, very social energy here. Okay, I'm feeling good about this reading here. So yeah, I would love to hear all about this. If those of you that pick pile number two, if this reading resonates for you, I would love to hear all about it. You can comment below here, but that is your reading, and that's the energy we're getting. So overall, this is a great reading for you, pile number two. Thank you so much for watching. Pile number three, those of you that chose yellow citrine, this reading is for you. So we're just going to put this over here to the side and see what we are getting here. All right, we are getting the Death card. Six of Coins and Six of Cups. All right. So we're already getting transformations here. There's a transformation happening for some of you here, pile number three. Okay, something's come to an end, and there's this new rebirth or a transformation going on here, okay? And I feel like this is a lot, for pile number three, a lot of relationship. I feel like there's a lot of healing going on for some of you, okay? I'm seeing success in a lot of things in all areas of your life here, especially relationships. Maybe you've just left an old partner. I feel like there's some sort of a transformation, some big change that has happened in your life right now, okay? And you're going through this rebirth, this beautiful new beginning is coming into your life right now, okay? With the death card, that's what I'm seeing already. There's some spiritual growth. I feel like you're letting go of the old and in with the new. Lots of changes, lots of transitions going on, whether you left an old job and you're heading into a new position, you left a relationship and you're heading into a new relationship, or you're just starting a new path in your life. There's a lot of beginnings going on for some of you here, pile number three. Okay, and these are really good beginnings. I'm getting like a lot of you going through a healing process right now as well, okay? And you're in harmony and you're understanding that that was not your life path and now you finally figured it out and you're heading towards success. You're heading towards your soulmate. You're heading towards your career path. Whatever makes you happy is where you are headed into this harmonious state for the rest of this year, okay? You are heading in that direction, all right? With the Six of Coins, I'm getting that you're supported by your spirit guides right now, okay? And I feel a lot of you need to be very grateful for, you know, things that ended for a reason. The choices that you made, there needs to be some sort of gratitude to your spirit guides or to whoever it is that you believe in, because this has happened for a reason. There's a new chapter opening up in your life and it's meant to happen this way. Okay, there's a lot of healing going on and it's in a good way. There's so much goodness coming in for you here, pile number three. Okay, I'm seeing generosity. I'm seeing people helping you. There's a lot of support around you as well. Okay, so the decision that you made was a good decision. It was a good choice. Whatever you decided to do, this was a good choice on you, pile number three. You're very supported in this decision right now, okay? Your spirit guides are fully in support of you. You can call on them and they will help guide you in the direction you need to go now, all right? That's there for you. And with the Six of Cups, I'm getting that there's almost like this nostalgic feeling, like you're healing through memories. You're feeling the moment for what it is. And you need to let go of your past now, okay, and move forward. Whatever happened, whatever ended up, whatever put you in a position of this rebirth or transformation or change, you need to allow yourself to forgive. There needs to be some sort of forgiveness here, okay? Spirit guides are letting me know there needs to be some sort of forgiveness because I feel like you have, you're holding a grudge. Some of you are holding a grudge. Some of you are not wanting to forget what happened. It's almost like, I can't believe this happened. How could this happen? How could they do this to me? Or how could my work do this? Why did it end up this way? It happened this way for a reason. Okay, because there's a better path for you and you're on that path now. This needed to happen in order for you to move into this direction that you're supposed to be on, that you're meant to be on, okay? So you need to heal, you need to forgive, you need to be grateful right now. And this year, the rest of this year is going to be all about that. It's all very emotional energy, just feeling the emotions of whatever is going on and healing from that and forgiving. You don't have to forget anything, but forgiveness is being requested from you, from the universe, from your spirit guides right now. That's what I'm getting right now. Okay. So the healing needs to take place. I feel like there's going to be a lot of harmony and success towards the end of this year. I feel like some of you are also going to get into a new relationship here. Okay. Cause you're moving on to better things. Life is going to be so much better. You made the right choice. Whatever happened, happened for a reason if it wasn't your choice that you made and it happened suddenly. Or it happened without you wanting it to happen. Okay, things are working out because the universe is pushing you towards the path that you're actually supposed to be on right now. It's going to take you into this happy place. But you need time to heal from everything. You need to forgive. You need to be very grateful for what's happened. All right, even though it doesn't feel that way for some of you right now, things are going to work out for the better. There's a reason why this happened. And if it was your choice, good on you because you're following your heart. So that's what spirit guides wanted to give you a message here right now for that. So this is the rest of your year: healing, forgiving, gratitude. New beginnings are coming in as well. So, you know, there's this death and rebirth, transformation, beautiful things. Okay, so that is your reading, pile number 3. Thank you so much for watching. Pile number 4, those of you that chose rose quartz, this is your reading for today. So this is your reading for the rest of the year and what's going on in your life. Okay, so let's see here. 5 of coins, 3 of wands, 5 of swords. So I'm already seeing that you're in a situation here, and the rest of the year is going to be a little bit challenging for you, okay? But I feel like you're a very strong person and you can handle this challenge. The universe is letting you know whatever challenges you face for the rest of this year are going to be, you're going to be victorious in them, okay? You're going to triumph. Things are going to work out. But there is some challenges coming your way for the rest of this year. There's some good challenges and then there's not so good challenges. Okay. So we're getting a 5 here twice. So there might be some conflicts, some sort of instability or chaos that you might be feeling right now. That you're going through. Okay. Things like almost like a turbulence energy. Maybe your finances are tight and you're worried about money and that's causing, you some grief or challenges in your life. Okay, so that feeling is there. I'm already feeling that energy from this reading here, pile number 4. Okay, with the 5 of coins, I'm getting that maybe you're feeling insecure in your finances right now, or you're feeling, or you're being hit hard with poverty. There's some struggles happening. Some of you might be experiencing unemployment, having a hard time finding a job right now. And really that's stressing you out to the max, okay? You're just feeling the pinch really hard right now. Just know that your spirit guides are there. Ask them for help and they will guide you in the right direction. Ask people around you that you're, you know, if they can help you. Ask for support from those around you right now, especially if you are going through this hardship right now, okay? This reading is all about challenges here for you, pile number 4, all right? But you're going to get through this. You're going to get through this. Have faith and have hope and believe that you will. And you will. Okay? Yeah, with the 5 of coins, I feel like there's a lot going on here. Okay? And you really need to not give up. Keep going and doing and overcoming all of this. Recover from that financial loss. It might be hard. But you can recover from this, okay, if you try hard enough. Do not give up. That's what I'm getting here from spirit guides. Do not give up because there is something out there waiting for you, all right, during these tough times right now. With the 3 of wands, I'm getting growth. There is going to be, there's going to be something good happening in your life towards November, October, November, around that time here, okay, with the 3 of wands. I feel like you need to have confidence in yourself. You need to get up and actually take action for your life, for whatever it is that you're feeling right now, the hardships. You need to take this and you need to take control of it. You need to take action and get in charge. Ride that momentum of motivation, whatever is going to get you into that motivated state to take action and make things happen for you, and to look ahead and see what it is that you need to plan out for and start planning it now, okay? Because I feel like you can. You're thinking, you're really looking at the whole picture for what it is, and you're looking, instead of looking at the negative, look at the positives, the possible positive that can come from you taking action. All right, spirit guides are saying you have to take action. You can't sit there and dwell on what's going on right now in your life. You need to get up and take action and make things happen right now for yourself. Some of you may feel like, I'm trying and it's not working. You know what? You got to just keep trying. Keep trying, try different avenues, try different things. Anything will help, right? If one thing's not working, try something else. Think outside the box. All right, think outside the box right now. I've got 5 of swords here. Okay, Five of Swords is tension. I feel like maybe there's some sort of arguments happening at home. Maybe at work, some of you that are feeling, you know, maybe you, I feel like some of you may have asked for a raise, right? And you're not getting it, or you're just not making enough money. So I'm seeing a lot of quarrels, disputes. Maybe some of you are being bullied. There's some sort of stress or hostility, tension. I'm feeling tension here as well. Okay, you need to stand your ground. You need to fight for what you want in life. All right, your spirit guides are with you in this as well. Okay, know that. Know that your spirit guides are with you. All right. Sometimes we have to make compromises. For now, temporary compromises are being requested of you, pile number four. Don't sit and don't dwell on past regrets or resentments. Don't seek revenge from people that have done something wrong to you. Okay, I feel like there's a lot going on here with this energy. And you're in a really tough spot right now. Know that it is going to get better. It's going to take time, but it will get better. All right? Your spirit guides are with you. So stand strong in your truth and stand strong and do not give up. Things will work out because you're capable. Look at you. You're standing here strong. Bring it, energy. Like, bring it. Throw it at me. Give me what you got. And you're going to be able to handle it and take it on like a total pro. Okay, just don't give up. Just stay strong. Remain strong at this time, pile number four. That's what spirit guides are asking of you, okay? So that's what your year is going to look like. There's going to be a lot of challenges, but you're going to be able to handle them. All right? The universe throws things at you that you can handle. So just know that and be strong. All right, so that's your reading, pile number four.